compared to the theoretical limit. Compared to the theoretical limit, we're looking at above 90% of those that meet NLEX. And how is that theoretical limit calculated? So that theoretical limit can be calculated based on the number of lanes that the design is running, and the speed per lane, four lanes running at Jensen gets you 2.5 gigabytes per second. The overhead due to savings can be reduced that by 20% down to 2 gigabytes per second. And then you need to account for the headers and the packet limiters, which costs you 20 bytes for every packet that you transfer. Since the system accommodates 256 bytes of payload, you're looking at 256 over 256 plus 20 multiplied by 2 gigabytes per second, and that gets you the maximum theoretical throughput of 1,855 megabytes per second.
Okay, so what's mid-1700? 1750 megabytes per second over 1855 megabytes per second maximum.
That is correct.
That's very impressive.
Thanks a lot, Brian.
Thank you. To purchase the Cyclone 5 GT FPGA development kit, visit our e-store at Altera.com or contact one of our distributors.
I'm Dave Olson.
And I'm Guy Tran.
On behalf of everyone here at Altera, thanks for watching. Today we're talking about some of the dev kit options available for these 7.5 FPGAs. We have multiple variants available directly from Altera, as well as our partners. We have variants with and without integrated transceivers, and even some with integrated SoCs. Some are targeted at specific applications, others are general purpose. Bottom line, we've got the right kit available for you today. Today specifically, we've got four different boards I'm going to share with you. The 7.5 GX kit with 3 gigabit transceiver support, the 7.5 E kit, which is targeted at industrial applications, 7.5 SoC kit with integrated encores, and we also have with us today our distribution partner, Matt Nika, to talk about their kit as well. The first board I want to share with you today is a 7.5 GX board with 3 gigabit transceiver support. Here we have it in a demo running on a PC. It's plugged in the PCI card of the PC, and it's taking data off the backplane, renaming it through the FPGA, and storing it into the DRAM on the card itself. It's using Altera's Avalon Memory Mask architecture that does the TLP decoding and decoding for you, saving about 1 man-month worth of engineering. That's a very efficient in this implementation. It's getting about 85% efficiency of the maximum theoretical throughput. This will be available as a reference design from Altera. Let's take a closer look at the 7.5 GX board. As you can see, mechanically, it's a PCI card. It does have the 7.5 150K logic element device, the GX device, with 3 gigabit transceiver support, 2 banks of DDR3 memory, 1 connected to the hard memory controller, 1 connected to the soft memory controller. It also supports flash and Petram as well. It has multiple interface options, including Ethernet, USB 2.0, SDI, SMA connectors for additional transceiver interface. It also has Altera's HSMC connector. This connector allows the user to connect to over 40 different boards from both Altera as well as our partners. Also on the board are several storage goodies you'd expect to find on a typical dev kit. LEDs, switches, push buttons, a character LCD display. Target applications for this device include embedded computing for I/O expansion for PCIe interfaced NPUs, communication applications both wire and wireless, consumer applications including displays, and industrial applications that require high-speed transceivers. Altera has also developed the 7.5 E kit for applications that do not require high-speed transceiver support, including industrial applications like programmable logic controllers, industrial Ethernet. In fact, the flexibility of the 7.5 platform makes it ideally suited for the multiple industrial Ethernet standards in the market today. Motor control is another excellent opportunity for this type of a kit, and it supports Altera's driver and chip reference design. Military applications, including software-defined radio, other low-cost applications concerned with size, weight, and power, such as medical, video analytics, surveillance, set-top boxes, etc. Taking a look at the 7.5 board a little bit closer, we've got the FPGA here in the center. We also have banks of DDR3 memory, flash, and SRAM on board as well. Additionally, it also has low-power DDR for applications really concerned with low power. It also has a host of other things you'd expect to find on a dev kit, push buttons, LEDs, Altera's HSMC connector for connecting to multiple third-party and Altera-supported vendor cards as well. Moving on to Altera's 7.5 SoC board, I'd like to introduce Jim Witten, based out of our Austin Technology Center, who will take you through the 7.5 SoC board and solution. Jim?
Thank you, Chris. I'm here at the Austin Technology Center, where we focus on everything embedded, including processors, software, tools, and IT. Currently, we have a Cyclone 5 SoC board and development tools. The board is running Linux. Let's take a closer look. So we're looking at our Cyclone 5 development board, which has a dual ARM Cortex-A9, along with a BoxBox FPGA. We have an integrated USB blaster. We have PCI Express. We have lots of serial connectors like Ethernet, USB, and PHY. We have an expansion header for additional sound. And you can learn a lot more about it when you go to our website. So let's look inside an SoC. So we have a CPU side and an FPGA side. On the CPU side, we have two Honor A9 ports connected to a main LED, and also a 4 PDR. On the FPGA side, we have PIO, and as well as other FPGA IC connected to the main LED. We have a Linux application on the CPU, as well as on the LED on the CPU side, as well as the FPGA side. So that's all cool, but I'm a software engineer, so let me show you the software tool. So what we're looking at here is the ARM DF5 Altera Edition. It is ARM's premium debugger. We are connected to forward USB blaster to the target. There's the standard features of source window, assembly, and register views. The unique feature of this debugger is a unified debug. It lets you debug both CPUs and FPGA. So let me show you how it works. So we're going to stop the CPU while it's running Linux. And at the register window, what you're going to see is the ARM registers on the CPU that gets updated. But the really neat thing about this is we can also look into the FPGA registers, which are right here. I hope you found this intriguing. The development kit, which will include a DFI license, will be available in April. That's it from Austin. Back to you, Rich.
Thanks, Dan. In addition to our fair design and development kit, we're proud to work with a number of partners to design, develop, and market their own Phison 5 FPGA kit. Here's now we're going to talk about their kit at Kaufman.
Thanks, Rich. Magnita designed the Phison 5 GX baseboard as a low-cost option for those who want to evaluate the Phison 5 features, including the transceivers. It's also an ideal platform for evaluating Altera's MIOS logical processor on Phison 5. Enabling low-cost development tools, the Magnita board utilizes the Phison 5 GX-T4 with 50,000 logic elements. Phison applications require a much smaller logic footprint. Let's take a closer look at the board. In the center of the board, we have the Phison 5 GX-T4 FPGA in a 672-pin package. 2.9 megabits of block memory and 6 transceivers running up to 3.125 gigabits per second. Unique on this board is the integrated 24-bit audio codec complete with 3.5mm jacks. This enables designers to easily integrate audio codec functionality into their end applications. Connected to the FPGA are common components used with today's FPGA-based systems. 32-bit wide DDR3 memory using the Phison 5 hard memory controller. 256 megabits of flash and 4 megabits of SRAM. 10, 100, 1000 megabits per second Ethernet. USB blaster for FPGA programming and debug. For those looking to add USB to their design, the board also includes a Cypress UV-USB 2.0 peripheral controller. Expansion capabilities and the ability to evaluate the Cypress 5 GX transceivers is provided via the Altera standard HSMC connector. To get part of the industrial market where multiple IOs are required, as well as the consumer market, including applications that require audio and or graphical user interfaces. Cypress designs are available to demonstrate how to interface to all the major components on the board, including USB, Ethernet, DDR memory, and the audio circuit. So, all in all, this board represents an ideal package for anyone starting their first design using Phison 5 GX FPGA.
Thank you, Catherine. There are additional Phison 5 boards in development from both Altera and our partners, including Phison 5 GT kit, supporting high-speed transceivers up to 5 gigabits per second. You'll support PCI Gen 2 up to 4 lanes, an industry first for low-cost FPGAs. We also have partner boards in development from PVD, a Phison 5 GX kit that will support PCIe, gigabit Ethernet, SFP interfaces, and also CAN bus. Also from PVD is a Phison 5 E kit supporting a motor control reference design. We also have a low-cost video circuit board coming from our partner Traffic as well. As you can see, Altera and our partners do have many kits available today in development. I know we have the right kit right now. For more details, please visit us at www.altera.com/products/devkits. I'm Rich Holland.
I'm Catherine Tucker.
And on behalf of everyone here at Altera, thanks for watching.